I'd like to call the town board meeting of the town of Lake Mills to order on January 10th at 8:00 PM at the town hall. The notice was posted at the town hall, the North End Boat Launch, the cul-de-sac on Finch Brothers Road, and also on the town's website. The second item on the agenda is the adoption of the agenda. Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to adopt the agenda as printed.
And I'll second.
Is there any discussion on the agenda? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the agenda as published, please say aye. Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. The agenda will stand as printed. Item three, approval of the minutes.
I can't help you there.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to approve the minutes as printed of the meeting from December 13th, 2016.
I will second that. All in favor of approval of the minutes as published, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign.
Then I have to abstain.
Because you weren't.
I wasn't here.
Item four, approval of the treasurer's report.
Now, do we have to?
Yeah, we got to go back to December 2016 when Santa came by and gave us a bunch of money. Thanks, Sharon, for fixing it up. I would motion to approve the treasurer's report for December 2016.
I'll second it.
Is there any discussion or questions? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the report as corrected, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. I guess it really wasn't corrected, was it? And now the January 2017 treasurer's report. I would motion to approve the report as printed.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the treasurer's report for January 2017, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. Item five, approval of general funding voucher.
I'll make a motion to approve January's disbursements of, please, you should make these numbers.
I know, I should.
$1,924,834.87.
And I'll second that. Is there any discussion?
Just a couple things. I see we waxed the floor. It's really nice and shiny. It looks good. The other thing is computer and camera. What's
that?
That's the squad.
Oh, okay. All right. That's all I was wondering.
All right. Any other questions or discussion? I would like to question the road salt. I was a little surprised. I thought we were going to come together on that. So I will look again. I guess before you shuffle tonight out of here, could you make a copy of that? I should have done it yesterday when I was here.
There's about three copies of it. You can just have one.
Yeah, I'd keep track of that, okay? All right, all in favor of approving the disbursements or the general funding vouching for January 10th, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. Vouching is carried. Item six, reports, the police report. Hi, Matt. Welcome to the new year.
Yeah, thank you. How's it doing? We had 39 hours of patrol, 9 3/4 hours of radar. We handled 3 calls of service. We issued 17 citations and issued 9 warnings. As you guys probably know, we had a truck go through the ice today. If you didn't know.
It was on the news, too.
Off of Bartles Beach. It's half submerged, about 100 to 150 yards off of Bartles Beach. I was out there with the city, and Warden Wallace was there. I just printed a couple things here just so you guys know in case you get calls on it, what the statutes are, a read on the removal of that vehicle. The warden gave them 30 days, which is what they're allowed. I was not happy with 30 days. It's going to be an ice block in 30 days. With the wind tonight, we don't have to worry about it freezing in there. It's in open water if you haven't been out there by Bartles Beach. Looking at our ordinance, it's trying to come up because a complaint was assigned to the township since it's in a lake. The second page under our public nuisance ordinance, I believe, okay, with the interfering of the navigable waters. That's left out there. Obviously, it's a hazard to snowmobiles, other motoring traffic at night, ATVs and other things. So I will be giving the guy a call and telling him I want it removed ASAP. It's not marked, meaning it's not taped or lit, but where it is, it's open water, so we shouldn't, and there's no snowmobile traffic right now, trails are closed, so we should be okay under that circumstances. We couldn't, fire department could barely get to it with their airborne, with the wind, it almost blew them off to get them out of the water. So.
Almost looked like I could have walked to shore. From the pictures, but I suppose
yeah.
That was skewed.
I don't know if they wanted to take that chance.
Yeah, sure.
So I will be following up on it tomorrow to get a hold of the guy. They're locals, one from Johnson's Creek, the owner is, the other one's from Jefferson. Hmm. So that's on it. Just in case you get calls on it, those are the ordinance. That may be something for our ice ordinance. If we do get things through, if we want them removed quicker, especially if they're exposed.
Yeah, I suppose that ice ordinance, we just talked about that tonight at the Joint Rock Lake. I've pretty much got that ordinance put together.
Okay.
Looking at a couple other lake management districts for some more ideas on speed and those kind of things. but that certainly could be in there.
I think if it's exposed, you know, if it's under the ice, under the water, you know, 30 days would be fine. That's up to them. DNR kicks in, they handle it, they find them.
And you have to have the right conditions to remove it.
The problem is, like, this half, right, yeah. Steve's or Topol's or whoever is going to remove it, but 30 days with it sitting out there, I mean, that's...
Half in, half out.
It's half out. Yeah. Plus, we're going to get calls on it.
Yeah. Right.
You know, as people who don't know what's going through are going to see it, call in a 911 call, and we're going to have to send somebody out there at least to make sure it's the only vehicle. So... But I just wanted to give you that.
And is there a state penalty, Matt, for that?
There is after 30 days.
But not before. The person who takes the risk of driving on the water.
There's a few large fuel spill or oil or something like that. It's regulated by the DNR. By reference, this is a vehicle. I just gave you what she was going under, meaning the warden. They got 30 days and get it out of the water. So.
Okay.
I think it's a hazard. In my opinion, it's going to be definitely a hazard.
So then what are the penalties after 30 days? Do you have any clue?
Yeah, it's in the statute. It's a $500 fine.
Yeah.
To start, and I believe it's a $100 service charge every day. It sits in there.
We were struggling a little with the penalties in the ice driving ordinance. That's why I was asking that. But you and I will go over that in the next few weeks.
But I believe our nuisance ordinance, public nuisance ordinance, is going to cover that since it says navigable body of water. So
yeah. Okay.
That's going to cover us with this vehicle for now. So hopefully we get it out of there in the next day or two. It's supposed to get cold tonight, and temperatures are supposed to go down once that freezes.
Yeah.
And I don't know how they're going to get it out. So.
Right. The responsibility of the driver who decides to drive upon the ice-bound waters of Rock Lake, the liability and all of the responsibility lies immediately with the driver. Just want to warn people of that they are taking their lives and their equipment at their own risk as they drive in the waters of Rock Lake. Well, thanks for your emergency response. I suppose that wasn't what you had planned to do this afternoon.
No.
Thank you. No one was injured, and there is no loss of life, and I guess we should be thankful for that, although it is a safety hazard.
And I did get your note on the ordinance reference meeting with the guy, and I do have some paperwork for it.
Work on that.
Okay. Other than that's all I do have.
All right. Thanks, Matt. Joint Rock Lake Committee report. As I alluded to, the Joint Rock Lake Committee will probably come before us in February to give their annual report. They did not want to wait until April at our annual meeting. They want to get a jump on it. They've been working on the ice driving ordinance and the pier ordinance, and I'm working right along with them on it. There was some discussion of this incident today at the meeting, but nobody really had any details. So thank you for your service on that, and Matt. How about the Planning Commission report? C.
Yeah, the Planning Commission did not meet on January 3rd. That's for the second month in a row. So there's really nothing new to report.
Lucky dogs. I'll see if I can help out there.
Yeah.
Well, maybe March.
March,
still
okay.
Any other committee reports?
Cambridge Fire EMS met about the middle of last month. Most of it was just housekeeping. We financially were setting pretty well. We had about $124,000 in cash, so we applied all but $30,000 to equipment replacement for fire and also EMS, because after buying the two new ambulances, we're kind of depleted that account. Yeah, I didn't want to use that word, but then the other big topic there was is we've also been approached by the town of Deerfield and the town of Marshall of possibly absorbing that area into our fire and EMS, but right now it's just some meetings we're going to, because they're obviously suffering the same problem as all their emergency services cost and trying to get enough funds to cover it, so that's kind of really about it.
Do you need fire protection too?
No, it would have been just EMS.
EMS.
Yep.
And that's an area that is between Deerfield, Marshall, and Cambridge.
Well, actually, it'd be Ryan Brothers does the city of Deerfield. So it would be the complete outlying area of the town of Deerfield. And then on the north side, where it goes from the interstate towards Marshall, would be that area there. So I know it. A couple of the EMS board people don't think it's a good idea because they would be, you know, stretched a little thin. But my opinion was we need to investigate it further, because if you take in a larger area, you're going to have a bigger equalized value, and also we could utilize some of those people as a labor offset. So we'll watch that unfold.
Okay. Thanks for doing that, Dave.
Yeah.
Do you want to just a spot for the closing of the nomination papers? Or?
Sure.
Okay.
Go ahead, Sarah.
I have received nomination papers from all of the board members sitting here and from no one else. So that will be our April ballot. What?
Slate.
Yep.
Which means that all seats are filed for and are uncontested at this time, and the incumbents are running with gleeful hearts.
Unopposed.
We still got the write-in campaign. Yep. We have until April to mess up.
We've been messing up left and right, you mean.
Yeah, right, yeah. That.
Okay, thank you, Sarah. Another clerk detail. Item 7, a period of public comment and questions for anything that is not on the agenda. Welcome. Take the podium and state your name and tell us what you're about.
John Pure from Shirley Hills. Back from December meeting. Said to write up something about the doing a trail up in Sherwood Hills, restoring it. So I put together a proposal with a budget, and I can pass that out. I'll just do that.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Being able to continue just restoring it on my own, I'll be continuing to provide the labor, but I'm still looking for a little advice on terracing some of the bridges to make them easier to walk up and down. And so the estimates are based on what I find off the internet for cost. If any or part of that could be offset by the town, that would be great. Then the other request out of this was to have that trail that starts on Woodfield Lane on the south, goes through the Conservancy, branches off to Sunset Circle, continues north on the other branch to reconnect with Woodfield Lane near Sherwood Hills, and then crosses from Woodfield to Bridle Path. That be named after Roland and Martha Liebenau, recently deceased, as town historians. Other I'm thinking just simple, the wood chips, some steps. That would be basically backfilled packed earth with retaining boards, and then signage. I'd been in my son's scout troop committee, so I spend money like I'm spending my own, so. Or, in other words, I'm cheap.
Frugal.
Frugal, yes. Yes.
I wonder if, where did the signs quotes come from? I'm just wondering if the one that we use would be competitive with that.
I just went off the internet. I would, if any or all of this were to be approved for budget items, I would be looking to source them locally, so if at all possible.
Sure.
I know the price of the Blaze stakes, but not the signage, because I shop at Ace here in town, so it's or in the city side, sorry, in Lake Mills.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I and how much those cost, and I buy them by the mittful, my own driveway. So those were the items I was looking at. There's two on the original, the old Rock Lake Homeowners Association walking trail map. You'll see one map did not include the T sections between upper and lower Shorewood Hills, because I have no idea where the old trail actually went. I could kind of figure out from traversing the Commons area where the old trail went between the two sections of Woodfield Lane and this branch that went out to Shorewood Hill or up to Sunset Circle. And It's more labor than I would care to expend on my, since I'm probably the sole person working on this. I'm trying to get some help from some scouts or something. I've been talking to some people that have given me the names of some of the scout leaders. I'm thinking Eagle Scout projects, but so that's the request, though, the proposal.
Anybody else in the neighborhood know about your efforts, John?
They do. I've been talking to my neighbors, mentioned the idea of one naming after Dr. and Mrs. Liebenau. That went over very well. Many of the other neighbors have mentioned they are now using it to go either running on the trail during the better weather or walking their dogs. Yeah. So it's there. I'm just looking to keep it cleared and try to improve the walkability of it.
Yeah.
So far all the comment has been positive.
Has this subject been introduced to the Homeowners Association?
Yeah, that's what I was wondering too.
I had mentioned it to Margaret and Meredith.
Mm-hmm.
My wife is on the just became a director on the Homeowners Association as well. But then when they were told, or they told me that it's a town of Lake Mills matter.
Mm-hmm.
So I have asked them, so I'm coming here.
I was just thinking maybe it would behoove us if we, I think the numbers are certainly outrageous. I mean, not outrageous.
Not
to
outrageous?
Do some maintenance, that they are not outrageous.
Okay.
And certainly we talked about the need for some signage, and I'm sure that there is some need for wood chips and erosion control. I wonder if it wouldn't behoove us if we put together a group or a committee of some kind that could oversee or make recommendations to us about the plans that are here. Would you have any idea of anybody who might want to work along with you?
I was given
too complicated.
I have to get the last name. Somebody gave me the name of somebody that's supposed to be a local landscaper who would be willing to give advice without necessarily doing the work. So that's, I am looking for that, or if the DNR has any recommendations as well, because I don't want to start making improvements and then find out that I'm actually bucking things.
Yeah.
But so far I keep I keep it line trimmed. I take the fallen trees and clear them off the path, cut through the. I had to reroute one section because one tree was just too big. And my wife did get me a new chainsaw for Christmas, so.
Oh,
all right.
Oh, trouble. What do you guys think?
No, are these properties, or were those obviously dedicated by the developer, but are those owned by the lots? Are they dedicated to the town?
They're all dedicated to the town.
Okay, and how wide are they?
They're supposed to be 35 feet wide at the narrowest points, I believe, 30 to 35 feet. And I'm looking for a trail that's probably 3 to 5 feet wide at some points, but as you get up on top of the moraine, and sometimes only 2 feet wide because of the trees.
Yeah. What about the one that's down there by your house, Hope, that you use to get to the lake? But there's one down Elm
that's
Point.
That's private, isn't it?
That's all private.
Oh, those are private easements that go through?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There is that little public space on Elm Point Road
leads
down to the little beach there.
Mm-hmm.
We have that, well, we had it marked.
Marked.
It's unmarked any now. I guess my thought is I'd like to see a couple of more heads in the shed. That's all my thought is. Wonder if we could recruit a couple of people to work along with you, and that we have some time to consider this and make a plan so that it's ready to go in the spring, figure out where we're going to allocate the funds from and go from there. I don't think the plan is that expansive. I do think that it's important that it be recognized as public property.
Yeah, and it's not huge by any means.
And,
I mean, for one person it is, but if you had help, it would sound
well, yeah, and certainly you have us here to help you figure out how we're going to go about this. But let's get a couple more people involved. That makes sense to you?
That makes sense for the improvements, and there's no issue as long as for me to just keep maintaining it.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay.
I don't have any problem with that at all. what is your email, John?
I put my cell number up on the top, but my email is, and might as well put it for both my wife and myself, JL, he is in Paul, UHR, @charter.net.
All right.
And I will try to get the first and last name of the person. I have a first name.
Okay.
I'm just going to have to go back and ask for the last name.
Let's find somebody else in the neighborhood that has the same thoughts that you do, and let's try to work forward. And this meeting should give the public an idea of what is proposed. Maybe you could put this improvement idea up on the website.
Okay.
And generate a little concern that way.
Did you put it on that Short Hills Facebook page?
I did not, because I was told this is a town matter, not
sure.
A homeowner's association.
Okay.
Been doing that.
If it does go up on the town page, you can just redact my
nice to be able
cell
to
number.
Find a couple more people.
Yeah.
All right, great. Thanks, John. Hard work.
Okay.
Winter months. Get this hard work done, and then you can go forward.
Yeah,
thank you for your time.
Yeah, me neither.
So, I mean, I'd like to go look at it.
Take that off.
See it.
So that's what his arrow means.
Great. Thank you for your work.
Bulldozer.
Anybody else have a public comment or question?
What?
How's that?
We were discussing.
You're messing with the audio.
What were you discussing? Let's hear it.
We were discussing exactly which trail that he's talking about, and it's the green one.
Yeah.
And we've never been back in there, so.
I have. After we found out that he was doing this, Joe and I hiked that
walk
whole thing.
Back there.
Yeah.
It's pretty hard to realize that it's public land.
Well, this part, is not marked at all. And
right.
You just kind of have to find your way through.
Mm. 15 years.
Just kind of skirt the property lines.
It is nice to be able to go back in there and you feel like you're
Okay, item 8, application reviews. A, discussion and decision on a request to hold a special event by Ragnar Events for the Ragnar Relay on June 10th and 11th, 2017.
They are available by phone. If you have any questions, nothing has changed, including the race director is the same this time.
Right.
I think
well, you know what this brings to the town of Lake Mills and to the city of Lake Mills as far as economic gain. Sure, it does the same for Cambridge and any other cities or municipalities that it goes through.
I think, correct me if I'm wrong here, Lee, but I think that the Trek 100 and the Ragnar are not the same weekend this year.
No, they're not, because they're going to sign up a team. Trek's going to have a team for sure. So.
So this is six.
For the Ragnar?
Yeah.
Yep. Is that right? Wow.
But 2 years ago, they had a team
they're
as well.
Yes. So 6-10 and 6-11.
6-9 and 10.
6-9 and 6-10. Yeah. We are lucky that it goes through our community at the right time of the day.
Yes.
I would make a motion to support the special event application for Ragnar Relay on June 10, 11, 17.
I will second.
Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the special event permit for Ragnar, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. Motion carries. Item B, discussion and decision on a request to hold a special event by the Watertown Archers for a fishing tournament on the Knickerbocker weekend, February 4th, 2017. They've been doing this for years. I asked them not to do it on the same weekend we were doing ours. They said they'd still like to do it. Doesn't seem to propose any major conflict as far as people or supervision goes, and so we agreed to say okay, or the Main Street Committee decided to say okay, it's all right. So we need to give them a special permit, and I would motion to do so.
I'll second it.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving a special event permit for the Watertown Archers for a fishing tournament on February 4th, 2017, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. Motion carries. Item 9, old business, an update on ordinance reviews. So I did meet with Tim Schwecke, who owns a consulting company which does work on municipal ordinance codification. And we met, I gave him our ordinance book, and he looked over it. He replied back to me, and I guess I just got that reply this morning. I did a little investigation. What he is involved in right now is a rewrite or a recodification of the municipal code, which is all of the ordinances of the town of Eagle. I spoke with their clerk today. She said they'd been dancing around cleaning up their ordinance book for a really long time. When Tim and I met, we looked just briefly at our ordinance book. He took it back home with him and sent me an email of all the recommendations that he had. One of the recommendations that he had is that we have a balance, a sheet of fees.
Oh, the fee schedule.
Which we already have.
Yep.
There are just some ordinances that may need to be looked at and are dated. Most of them, though, are the ones that we're working on now. There are some that are out of order in their indexing, which I don't think is so complicated either. I was trying to determine the difference between a town's ordinance book and a municipal code. Basically, they are the same thing. That's what I've gleaned from the Towns Association. Tim is not really very well versed in the ordinances that you and I would like to tackle, the police department ordinances, but I think that we can dredge up enough examples to clean that up. He would be much more comfortable working with our subdivision and land use ordinances. And those are the ones that our engineer pointed to that have some holes in them. But I think at this point, I guess I'd like you guys to look over that. I mean, this is a big process. If we decide to take on a total recodification of our ordinance book, that's a big project. But if we could have him look over some of the indexing and get that straightened up. The town of Eagle is working with a committee, a different committee than their planning committee, on the recodification. That would be an option for us, but I don't think we're quite right there yet. I think we should start by reviewing what his recommendations are. I'd like you guys to have a little time to think about it and a little time to look at your ordinances, your ordinance books. And then I think you and I, Matt, should sit down and pull those things together that we feel like we need in the police department. And then as we go forward into the new year, perhaps we might hire him to do some work on our subdivision ordinance along with the planning committee. I think they're the group that should be looking at that. He also reminded me that comprehensive plans are always needing to be updated. But I gleaned quite a bit of information from him, and I want you guys to look over that email and look at the recommendations that he has made, and then compare that to what you think the ordinance book should be looking like. You guys too, because we're the ones who have to administer those things. He was looking at some shortcuts, you know, little indexes so that you could, the clerk in the town of Eagle said that they have some outlines for if you would like a conditional use permit or if you would like a subdivision of the list of things that would need the steps that need to be done. And I know we have some of that, but we don't have all of that. I'm not even sure if our ordinance book, the one that's on the desk in there, is the most current or most up to date, because I don't think the fee schedule is in there, otherwise he would have seen it. So I think we've done a little bit of work. I wasn't totally blown away by his recommendations, but it does give me pause for concern. The clerk from the town of Eagle said that they had budgeted $20,000 last year for it and $30,000 for it this year.
Whoa. So,
but Tim is also acting as their town planner. He reviews everything that they do as they go along. We're looking at a much larger township.
Just going to ask that.
It has a lake management district, so that's where their lake responsibility is, and it has a population of about 6,000 people, which is much smaller than the town of Lake Mills, but we still need to take a look at all of our ordinances and make sure they're up to snuff. Things have gotten added, and they've just gotten indexed in the wrong place, so I think it maybe is just a cleanup thing that we can tackle over a number of years.
Has he charged us anything yet?
I have not received a bill. I did not ask that question. I'd like you guys to look over his recommendations. And
did you email it to me or something? Or
not yet.
Oh, okay.
Not yet. I just got it. And okay. I thought, I need to sit down and look at it a little bit. So that's kind of where I'm at with that. I think we can accomplish quite a few things. The Lake Committee is working on the ice driving. They're working on the pier ordinance. That stuff is going out for review. Matt and I can work on the police ordinances, and then it's basically the subdivision ordinance, and as long as the planning committee doesn't have a whole lot of activity right now, maybe this is the time for them to take a look at that. But you guys look over the email that Sarah will send you and see what you have to say, okay?
Okay.
Put that on the agenda for next month as old business, too. Item 10. I told Tim this, and I'm going to say this to you. I am not an engineer, and I am not a consultant, but I don't want to get caught with our ordinances down around our knees when something comes our way. So it was a learning experience. Your input would be much, much more helpful. Item 10, new business. Discussion and decision on the 2016 budget amendments. Sarah.
These are just copies. We'll sign the one I've gotten. I'm going to pass them down if you'd like. So this is our year-to-date 2016, how we wound up. Pull it up for our viewing audience here. Most of it fits on the screen there. So altogether, revenue-wise, we came out ahead to the tune of $32,645.17. On the expense side, that's where we have a couple of things to shuffle around. We're fine. We underspent by almost $40,000. but we have a couple of categories to just shuffle around here. So we had, I can't see it all on my screen here. Let's move it over. Here we go. Public safety went over by $2,200. And clean boats, clean waters. I haven't gotten the grant paperwork done to get reimbursed for that yet, so I that looks like it's over, but it won't be in the end. Rock Lake, though, went over a little bit. We had some repairs and things to do on the launches and the piers themselves and the launch areas. What else? This cable fees to the city, we underestimated what that was, and that's really not anything we control, so. Any questions you're seeing in here anywhere? Luckily, we were under by 5,000 just and change in our general government budget. So I'm allocating that surplus out to the areas that need it, and then taking the rest of it from this engineering piece that is not part of the highway budget and we did not use. So that's the other page here is our resolutions would do exactly what I just explained.
Okay, so we're gonna read these budget resolutions.
So the first one would be 2017-01, and go from there.
Okay, budget resolution of the Town of Lake Mills, Jefferson County. A resolution changing the 2016 budget of the Town of Lake Mills, adopted by a two-thirds majority of the entire membership of the Town Board, will be it resolved by the Town Board of the Town of Lake Mills as follows, that the sum of $2,258.86 be transferred from the general government account to the public safety account. Is there a motion?
I'll make that motion.
I will second it. Are there any questions or discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving this first budget amendment, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. The amendment is carried. Budget resolution changing the 2016 budget of the Town of Lake Mills, adopted by a two-thirds majority of the entire membership of the Town Board. Be it resolved by the Town Board of the Town of Lake Mills as follows, that the sum of $118.35 be transferred from the general government account to the miscellaneous expenditures account.
Make that motion for 2017-02.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving this second budget resolution, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, and all opposed, the same sign. Third one, a resolution changing the 2016 budget of the Town of Lake Mills, adopted by two-thirds majority of the entire membership of the Town Board. Be it resolved by the Town Board of the Town of Lake Mills as follows, that the sum of $2,675.14 be transferred from the general government accounting and $3,276.62 is hereby transferred from the Public Works Engineering account for a total of $5,951.76 to the Culture and Recreation account.
I'll make that motion.
I will second it. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the third budget resolution, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, the same sign. The resolutions are carried. Sarah?
Yes, ma'am.
That's an amazing amount of accounting. I remember having 6, 8, 10
budget resolutions. Yeah, I was going to say, the list is really small. Which one do you want signed, Sarah? The one that Pope has?
Yeah, I've got a few things for you guys to sign afterwards.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you. Item B, board expense sheets. I see Sarah has provided us with a new expense log.
This has the
different
current mileage rate.
Mileage rate on it.
Which actually went down a little bit, 0.5 cent.
All right. Is there anyone who has any expenses to be approved?
Yeah, I do. I found most of the rest of my election stuff from last year.
All right.
The only one I'm missing is some stickers, but.
I thought it said postage and liquor.
Hey, Sometimes you have to.
You know, that last election, I was tempted to bring a bottle of champagne. Just because it was done.
Okay. Sharon, it's good to have you back. Dave, it's good to have you back.
Wow.
We really had to limp along last month.
16 years, I've never missed a meeting.
Hey, it's not a contest. It's not a contest. It's okay. Item 11 is correspondence. I bet you got a whole folder of it.
Yeah, I have some stuff. Yeah. If you recall the violation we've been kind of tracking along the lakeshore, it has been resolved and no further action is required according to Jefferson County, so I thought you'd be happy to hear that.
Hmm. Oh.
Okay. A very current letter from the City of Lake Mills Light and Water regarding the reconstruction project coming to South Main Street here. Several electric utility poles owned by Lake Mills Light and Water need to be moved, and here's all the details about that. I'm sure it went to every address on the Main Street path that's being reconstructed, so may or may not attain, but so you're aware.
It's going to be right in your front lawn.
You gave me this one about, there's a couple of these where the Department of Natural Resources is informing us of proposed donations of land. I don't think we need to do anything.
No, but where's that letter I had? Here's another one.
Okay, more?
Yeah.
People need some tax write-offs. We need land.
Department would like to inform you of a grant of the Knowles Nelson Stewardship Program for the donation of, I believe, where did I read it? 42-acre parcel in the town of Lake Mills.
Well, this one says it's been tentatively awarded to support the acquisition of the 42-acre parcel. I don't know who's doing it. The Knowles Nelson Stewardship Program has been tentatively awarded to support the acquisition of a 42-acre parcel in the town of Lake Mills by Natural Heritage Land Trust for conservation and public recreational purposes.
And we can ask for more information, and we also can give them the thumbs up or the thumbs down. I'm pretty sure this is land that is located within the marsh area south of Rock Lake. And but I guess a phone call would be prudent to figure out where it is.
You want to make that or do you want
me to make that? Yeah, I can do that. Figure out where it is.
All right.
42 acres.
Yeah. Okay. The other one says, inform you of the proposed donation of 5 acres of land for the Lake Mills Wildlife Area in the town of Lake Mills, and the proposed donation of 0.79 acres of land for the statewide public access project in the town of Koshkonong. Sites are shown on the attached map, but that's south of the lake.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Public notice to the customers of the Lake Mills Water Department that they have filed to increase water rates. Hmm. That went to everybody in town. The Urban Towns Association sent us our bill for their the Urban Towns Committee, separate from the Wisconsin Towns Association, so they included some information on what they're up to and what their plans are. The UW Extension Local Land Use Planning and Zoning January through May 2017 teleconference planner is here, different educational opportunities in that field. And then we got our quarterly Baxter and Woodman newsletter, if anybody's interested in what they have to offer in engineering.
Okay, thanks.
And that would do it.
So as we all have to have board review training then too.
Yeah, I was thinking about that too. Because we all are up for retraining, right?
Yeah.
Lee, did you do it last year? Board of review, or was
it? I did do it last year.
Oh, yeah. So then you're good for a year. So that's just you and I then.
Yeah. And we'll probably get that at a district meeting. I did see the January. Well, I saw the schedule for district meetings.
Yeah,
I didn't crack the town's newsletter yet for January. But those district meetings are coming up pretty quick here in February and March.
Did you do the lost line? Is that what you did?
I did the, I got the video.
Okay.
And then,
I wonder if we can still use that.
Yeah, I think so.
And I had a.
That's what we did the last time.
All on video.
To check and see if there's any update.
Update on that. See if it's changed. The format has changed. Item 12, meeting scheduled. February 7th, 2017. Joint Rock Lake Committee at 6 and the Planning Commission at 8. And look at this. Our next town board meeting is on my favorite day of the year.
Wow.
Tuesday, February 14th at 8 p.m.
Aren't you going to be a little busy that day?
I'm going to be retired, remember?
Oh, that's right. You will.
That's right. Okay.
And I will have a tax settlement with the county on February 13th. That's Monday, so okay. We'll have to have that checked. Signs so that I can take it down.
Okay, you know
but
where we are.
But you'll have them made out then anyway, so
yeah.
Just pick it up.
Okay, I'm just going to make sure we get that signed on Sunday, February 12th.
Right.
Lincoln's birthday. Okay, I'll make sure that gets done because I will be busy that week.
Okay.
Anything else?
Make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second it. All in favor?
All right.
Meeting is adjourned.
We need that one.